Well, that is a wrap on day one of SEC Media Days. I'm Alex McDaniel with AL.com, coming to you from the Hyatt Regency in Hoover, Alabama. I'm joined by Andrew Gribble and Mike Herndon. Mike, I want to talk about just a quick recap of SEC Commissioner Mike's live this morning. He had a few interesting points. Could you share some of his highlights?
Well, he reiterated his advocacy of a Power 5 autonomy and basically reiterated his threat that there may be a split into a separate division if that autonomy is not granted. Talked a little bit about the SEC network, most of which has been covered before. One of the interesting new things he brought up was this idea of a new bowl structure in which some of the second, about five or six of the second tier bowls will have teams assigned to them instead of picking their own teams from the SEC hierarchy.
And now looking at Florida and Vandy this afternoon, it's kind of an interesting dichotomy between, you know, Will Muschamp. There's a lot of chatter about, is he fighting for his job, especially after last season? And then you kind of have the new kid on the block, Derek Mason, coming in with all this ambition. Can you give us a few highlights from those pressers?
Well, I thought it was interesting. Will Muschamp said this is the most complete team he's had in his 4 years there and the most offensive weapons he's had in his 4 years there. That bodes well if true. The players that I spoke with, particularly Jeff Driscoll, said they don't feel any pressure to save his job. They're going out to play for them. So see how they do. And then obviously the big question for Derek Mason and the one that he keeps getting asked is about his quarterback. He's got several that are in the competition. Just added another one in a transfer from LSU, Steven Rivers. Not ready to make that decision. Going to play that on until the fall, and that's as we expected.
All right. One interesting thing about Media Days is that every media member here gets a ballot to choose an all-SEC team. So guys, I want you guys to think about it. Who are some of the sleepers, the guys that are floating under the radar that you think are going to make this team? Andrew, let's start with you.
Yeah, I got a couple, and I voted for him on our AL.com team earlier, and one is Tennessee wide receiver Marquez North. You know, he was a freshman last year, played for a team that didn't get much attention because Tennessee wasn't very good, but he got better and better as the year went on, played really well against Alabama and had a really nice stretch there near the end in November, but then he got hurt at the end of the year, just didn't do it all that much, so people aren't really talking about him as much. I think he'll have a big year, potentially up to a 1,000-yard season. Another guy that Alabama fans might remember is Chris Jones, the defensive tackle of Mississippi State, just kind of a five-star kind of guy, got better and better as the season went on as a freshman, and he could really start putting up big numbers for a Mississippi State team that's going to be a lot better this year.
What about you, Mike?
I think there's a defensive end at Missouri who played behind two really good defensive ends last year, Marcus Golden, who still had double-digit tackles tackles for loss despite not being a starter last year. I think he's a guy that's primed to step forward and put up some big numbers this year. And then there's a cornerback at LSU. I think once you get past Vernon Hargreaves at Florida, who's going to be that other SEC corner? All-SEC corner is a big question mark. I think Tre'Davious White at LSU is a guy who had a great first year at LSU, and on that defense, I could see him having a big year and stepping forward.
All right. Well, thanks, guys. Remember, you can keep up with all the action at SEC Media Days by checking out AL.com.